Hello, future citizen. Welcome back to the continuing educational series, Unity. Track 7, Strength Through Our Humanity, Loaded.
What does it mean to be human? A question our ancestors before the Great War asked then, and one we ask now. However, today the answer has never been more clear. We as humans are creatures of great compassion, creativity, and caring. While times are indeed tougher now than ever, it is our duty as humans to uplift our fellows from the ravages of the world and together build a future. We as humans care for our children, we love our families, we bond with our friends, and we show empathy for those in need, and mercy to our enemies. It is because of our humanity that we as a people rose and grew to become the dominant beings on this planet. It is true we used many weapons, both small and great, on one another as a disjointed collective. But all of us also created works of art, music, and culture that span the globe. Even now, we still hold open many of the wounds of the past. The people of Quebec may be our enemies, the people of the NGR may be our enemies. But we are still brothers and sisters who have more in common than openly admitted to. And in time, we shall show another human trait to our siblings that is not understood by our true enemies. Forgiveness.
We are human, never forget that.
The Coalition, as you well know, we are whispered of as the bad guys. While nothing could be further from the truth, you have taken your first steps to discovering the truth, and with that, on behalf of the state and the Emperor, we thank you for taking the time for listening and learning.
So what do the bad guys of the Coalition States believe in that makes us so evil?
We understand that some of this transmission will conflict with your preconceived notions, and that you will wish to object to some of the following material. This has most likely been told to you time and time again by those who consider themselves free, and yet live in lawless communes under the watchful gaze of despots, tyrants who will lie to you to maintain your hate of us and keep control of your mind.
So please continue viewing, and judge for yourself if we the Coalition States sound like lawless warlords and tyrants who wish to control you all the while consorting with undesirable beings.
Family, community, kinship. The three strongest pillars of the Coalition's foundation from which our Emperor decrees all laws and the future path for prosperity of our nation and our people. Family is important. Without children, we have no future, and must secure a future for humanity's children. Not only your own children. Your children will be born into a society as citizens by birthright that you have patiently secured for their future. They will have access to education, medicine, and food which the territories outside our borders have little to no access to. Imagine the hardships you had to endure, the fights you had to participate in with vile beasts, cannibals, scrappers, mercenaries and other foul terrors. As a citizen, your child will have a future free of random violence from such things. It is true crime can and does happen anywhere. But your progeny will also be part of a society with security, law, and due process. We welcome each and every family seeking a future to join in our empire, and it is no hollow promise that within our secure states we deliver on this promise. As a citizen you will have the duty and responsibility to contribute, but unlike the lawless wastes, your contributions will be met with the right to ask and receive for help from the state you are a member of. You, your family, your children, and their children will support the empire with loyalty, hard work, and civil service. In exchange, your family will have the right to justice, self-determination, education, food, shelter, medication, and security.
What warlord in the wastes has it written and enforced by law that you as an individual have the right to such things?
Furthermore, your family will become a part of a greater community. Each community is supported by Coalition military personnel, state-provided medical personnel, and tradesfolk from across our empire. It is, however, still your community. But what makes a community that is stable and worth living in during these hard times? Yes, your family. And your friends. Each community, no matter how small, is the salt of the earth and the true backbone of the empire. Farmers, artisans, soldiers, craftsmen from all across the region support one another in many ways. As a citizen, you are a vital part of the empire, no matter how small you may seem. All citizens are vital to the empire, and the empire is a vast network of small, once independent villages who possess the wisdom to share the fruits of their community with their neighbors, which in turn share with the cities, who in turn share with the empire. We all stand under the same banner. And by pledging your oath of citizenship, you become a member of a greater machine. A machine that stamps out hunger, poverty, and crime. Even on your worst days, you can look up at our flag, and know, your efforts make you a part of something greater. Take strength from knowing that the states value your dedication. Kinship is what we as humans are all about. Those looking in from the outside brand our emperor as a tyrant lord fueling so-called human supremacy and hate. These lies are nothing more than blatant heresy being shouted into the wind by the jealous, the spiteful, and the wicked. We must band together as a tribe, as humans, as individuals for mutual cooperation and protection. But are we as humans superior? The simple answer is yes. Yes, we are better, in many ways. We are beset on all sides by monsters of all sorts, and we still stand as a community. And that is the important part. For an easy breakdown, the hive lands in the north ravage the northern borders of Tolkien. And yet they turn to mystics and magic to cure their ills, summoning forth creatures lacking in civility to do the fighting for them. Magic has failed them every time, and yet they have not learned from each painful mistake. Meanwhile, Laszlo has become a land of magic, using warlords carving out their own small feudal kingdoms, constantly warring with one another, only setting aside petty grievances and insults to defend their communal borders long enough to resume the infighting. While their mastery over magic is hard for their enemies to rival, they are dead set on continuing a magic and ego-fueled cold war among one another, only to attain greater power to expose and humiliate those they fight with. And we do not have to do a thing to defend ourselves from them, since they are too busy attacking one another. The magic zone ruled by the despot Lord Dunskin is by far the worst of the lot, a land where magic is not only used for subjugation, but to raise the dead, commune with demons, and consort with monstrosities from unknown realms. They do this openly and with reckless abandon, and if you are from the wastes, then you already know the tales of evil that flow from those blighted lands.
And those are the established areas that pretend to have some semblance of order. It would indeed require a video series all on its own to explain the other breeds of monsters that roam the lands and dimensional aggressors that plague the race of man.
We are superior, not because we are born human. We are superior because of our humanity. Unlike those listed before, we have set aside our ego as a group, and taken up arms to fight alongside one another against our mortal enemies, so that our fellow humans, even the ones we may as individuals dislike or hold in contempt, have the freedom to seek a better life for themselves. We are superior because we can feel compassion. We are superior because we create. We are superior because we aid those in need. We are superior because we invent and build. An individual can become powerful indeed, but we are superior because we make those around us more powerful willingly. To say we are merely human supremacists is a bold lie. Every bolt that holds together a building, every switch in the cockpit of an aircraft, every thread in a shirt, they were mined, forged, grown, designed, built, assembled, refined, tested, by whom? Us. We are superior because of this, our ability to come together, work together, fight together, and grow together.
We build, they scavenge. We raise our young, they steal slaves. We teach and train, they break without understanding. We sow and plant, they ravage.
The difference is easy to see, is it not? We humans are superior because we worked for it, and continue to work for it every day. Through blood, sweat, and sacrifice. They will claim we are elitists, but I ask you, especially those who have lived in the wastes, what have they built, grown, or cultivated? But you may ask, how did we get this far? What gives us such rights to such claims? The Emperor Karl Prosek has decreed a certain set of values that are the cornerstones of our society and complement the pillars in which our nation stands.
First is the right to self-determination. Each person under our banner is free to choose their own path in life. The tools are there and the state is happy to lend a hand to those who are motivated to better themselves. Whether through trade, education, health, or service, each man, woman, and child has the full right and responsibility to choose their path under our banner, doubly so when pursuing improvement of oneself or their community.
Second, we shall seek more territory to sustain our population. Before the war, there were no raiders or dimensional threats. By decree of the Emperor, we always seek to secure and reclaim fertile land for agriculture. This in turn fosters prosperity on many levels, such as security, employment, living space, and of course for better quality of life for everyone.
Third, a strong identity in our nation and our shared humanity. The coalition is comprised of hardworking individuals from all walks of life, and we all share the same dreams, hopes, fears, and losses. No one else in the world can share what it feels like for a human when they feel loss. Our banner may inspire dread and contempt from our foes, but fellow people can always find comfort knowing that those standing under it share the same ideals and live to serve the same purpose in seeking a greater tomorrow.
Fourth, no foreign interests given undue power. Even if like-minded powers arise that match our own in spirit, none shall influence our state, nor the Emperor, nor her people. Those found taking bribes to lobby on behalf of outside influences are dealt with swiftly and harshly. As the first loyalty we have is the same as the Emperor's. to our nation and her people, not to foreign powers which seek to undermine our values or tear down our nation to become a fractured, lawless cesspit similar to their own.
Fifth, social programs shall be placed, monitored, and maintained by the state to provide programs for the disabled, the hungry, unemployed, elderly, veterans and so forth. Every person is vital in some way to keep the empire stable. Each person regardless of status will still have opportunities to seek out ways to improve their standing. As such, social aid programs are a responsibility of the state to uplift those in need so they can stand on as equal footing as possible with the general populace.
Sixth, immigration, infiltration, and deportation. While we would like to take in each person on good faith, there are those who would seek to undermine our carefully designed empire. Immigrants are strongly vetted to ensure only those that meet a rigid criteria gain citizenship. Infiltrators are punished harshly by the Codex of Laws to dissuade further attempts by bad actors, and those who are deported or exiled are among the worst, for they have been granted every right and opportunity, only to turn against their benefactors with treasonous intent.
Seventh, all citizens have equal rights and equal obligations. No law or decree will ever favor one group over any other, whether civilian, civil service, military, or otherwise. The state will grant no ruling that shows favoritism to any other group. The coalition is a meritocracy in its very heart, and those that do the best will be the ones to rise through the ranks. Equally, expectations are the same concerning responsibilities, and those that are unable to meet the demands of their path shall give way to those that are better suited.
8. Abolishment of unearned income. This includes but is not limited to theft, slavery, usury, and extortion. Theft and extortion are expressly criminal acts and are punishable by law within coalition territories. Usury likewise is charging more for a loan or service than by value, as such a fair trade policy is in effect in the economy and value shall not be added on top of value. Slavery is strictly reserved for criminals as a part of the justice system, and is an illegal trade. No citizen nor civil servant shall own, possess, or trade in slavery. Only those sentenced for criminal activities under Imperial Provision 1.31 Sec 36 are legally under the auspice of being stripped of imperial rights and privileges, to serve in the status of slavery.
9th, personal enrichment from war is a crime. Any act of seizing assets, personnel, trade goods, information, or other acts of profiteering is a criminal act punishable by military court. The state reserves the right to confiscate assets and distribute them as needed for the good of the empire and her citizens.
10th, national monitoring of large-scale for-profit entities, to maintain stability and to prevent monopolization. Corporations are regulated by the state to ensure affordability for the general populace of trade goods, to prevent said entities to gain undue influence over the governmental system to lend themselves undue rights which places their interests above the interests of others, and to aid in times of emergency should the need arise for the production of emergency services or equipment.
11th, support for retirement welfare. Among the most vulnerable populace, aged 55 plus, programs are in place to ensure citizens receive proper housing and medical care as needed. Retirement funds are based on overall contributions to the state based on years of gainful employment, military service, and overall needs.
12th, indiscriminate punishment for terrorists. Civilians can expect the state to deal with such criminals quickly and with extreme prejudice. Terrorism from without and from within is not tolerated, and all those charged with said crime in a military court will be punished to ensure the safety and security of the coalition and the population.
13th, education is to conform to a practical life. Basic education is provided, in mutual funding from the Imperial Education Fund, which is supplied by taxation of the public. All children have the right to an education regardless of societal or economic background. Gifted students are eligible for higher education to be paid for by the state via educational grants if they cannot afford higher education due to economic status.
14th, child labor laws. No youth is eligible for full-time employment until they have reached the age of 16. Those under 16 may work only in a part-time capacity of no more than 4 hours per day within a family-owned business or with parental consent in other private businesses. Nor may children work in hazardous or heavy labor activities, including fabrication facilities or machine operation. Any task with a viable risk to health or safety is prohibited. Youth physical fitness programs are also in place with interested parties encouraged to participate.
15th. Legal opposition is in place to curtail the spread of lies published or distributed by members of the press. Fact-checking is both endorsed and supported by the state and private entities to ensure the public is not influenced by propaganda nor falsehoods published in disguise as the truth. Foreign influence in the press is deemed unlawful as it may be used to incite or distract the populace.
16th, the right to health and wellness. Distribution of materials considered unhealthy is strongly prohibited. Drugs poison the body, and propaganda poisons the mind. The coalition regulates and seeks out illicit materials such as drugs and pornography for destruction. The emperor wishes all persons the chance to be healthy and productive and polices such materials studiously to help protect the populace from the ravages of such diabolical materials to aid them in their personal path of self-betterment. Now that you are familiar with the building blocks of our society, I must ask you to think for a moment and consider. Is the coalition evil? Are we really the evil bad guys you have heard whispers about around the campfire? It is a sure bet you probably do not agree with all 16 of the decrees placed forth by the emperor, but what is life like outside our borders? What is life like in the lands controlled by those that participate in using magic? What is life like by those ruled over by inhuman creatures? What is life like in the pockets of land ruled over by those who need weapons to enforce their laws? Perhaps, viewer, it is time for some hard truths.
Do not give pause in your beliefs. Unnatural invaders have the power, both psychic and magical, to influence your judgment. To listen to their words is to open oneself to evil. Stay clean. Stay pure. Kill them without hesitation or remorse, knowing that your actions save the human race.
Magic is inherently corruptive and evil. We all have met someone we argued with and wished that they would just be quiet, or better yet, to make them just see our point of view. Why use words when you can just wave your hand and make another person forget, or force thoughts into their mind? We have captured countless spell users over the years. Almost all of them have at least one get out of trouble card hidden up their sleeve. 93% to be exact. That is over 9 out of 10 have the ability to invade your mind and rob you of your will. They can change the laws of reality to do your thinking for you.
Scary stuff, if you think about it for a moment.
They have no accountability neither. When something goes wrong and a rogue spell burns down a home or demonic entity runs off to do whatever they want, most spellcasters just shrug it off and move on, not shouldering the responsibility of the destruction they invoke. We already mentioned they raise the dead too. Imagine fighting your best friend's corpse, or your mother's corpse, or a sea of recently dead children. They will do this to gain the upper hand in battle, not only using their power to fight against you, but to defile someone's loved ones.
Magic is a thing from the rifts. Its energies are alien and corrupting. Those who are foolish enough to use it are placing all life in danger, for the energies are unstable and unpredictable. Magic attracts the supernatural. Magic is our doom. Do not trust it, nor those who use it, lest you are ready to betray all you believe in.
The Federation of Magic is a sworn enemy of the Coalition. Deal with them as you would deal with a psychopath who seeks to enslave and defile your daughter. If you don't cut them down in such a manner, they will have their way.
Of the mercenaries and violent prisoners captured from the Federation, 87% have admitted to seeing the dead raised. 15% have admitted to participating in necromancy. 74% have engaged in blood magic. 82% have summoned hostile unknown entities. 12% have sacrificed a human life in magic rituals. 41% have captured and sold human slaves. 22% have made pacts with demonic forces. 37% have used spoiling magic which harms the natural surroundings. 79% have murdered coalition soldiers. 51% have murdered coalition civilians.
Make no mistake, we are fighting to ensure our future and the future for generations to come, but with that many admissions to wrongdoing, one should ask, what are they fighting for? Are they fighting just for themselves, or has the corruption of magic allowed them to suffocate their own desires for power, led down a path to fight for something even more sinister?
But what of psychics? We have pity for our cousins. The rifts and strange energies have warped them to be somewhere between us and the unclean demon worshippers. They are less than human, but at the same time they cannot help what they have become by forces outside the control of nature. It is true they walk among us as citizens, as helpful folk only seeking a place in the blighted ruins of our once great civilizations. And we do share this world with them, and many have distinguished themselves among our loyal and brave soldiers, but keep an ever watchful eye on our cousins. For the forces against us, the darkness just out of the corner of the eye, will prey on them and whisper venomous words in the shadows. So they can be just as dangerous, if not more so, than any horror visiting our home, For when a psychic turns treasonous, you may not see them coming.
If you are a psychic seeking citizenship, then you have already filled out the proper forms 114F and 221S in accordance with the PRP, Psychic Registration Program, and are most likely waiting for your IC, identification coding. However, if you have not filled out the proper forms, please speak to the administrative staff at one of our coalition state embassies. Form 82SF is required for psychics seeking military enlistment and or security details. Enrollment for psychics is encouraged.
It should be noted that in response to the high incidence of genetic anomalies in humans since the coming of the rifts, the coalition has established reproductive policies to defend humankind's gene pool from contamination by alien/mutant genes. As people, we have certain desires and physical needs.
Unlike in the Outlands, some things are regulated to maintain our humanity. If we do not, we risk losing our identity to outside influences. So we will momentarily cover the taboo topic of sexual relations. Here in the Coalition States, sexual relations between normal human citizens and DBs, dimensional beings, or human mutants are strictly forbidden, and any progeny that may arise from such unnatural unions are sometimes euthanized for the safety of the citizenship, as with many unknowns are at play and the risks too great for the community as a whole. Although more commonly, the parent will be stripped of their status and along with their progeny, exiled from the empire. Human mutations are potentially dangerous aberrations that make the unfortunate soul less than human in far too many recorded cases. This does not mean there is no sympathy for these people, and as often as we can, compassion and reason are our guides to attempt to rectify the situation. This is because the mutants' loss of humanity is not of their own doing, they are the victims of forces beyond their control. As such, human mutants are never knowingly allowed into the cities except under special provisions and going through the proper channels for authorization permits. To add insult to injury for both civilians and military personnel, it also bears mentioning that many dimensional beings may be carriers of unusual, virulent, or fatal diseases or viruses. It is true we have lived for countless millennia with sexually transmissible ailments. Dimensional beings may be host to a pathogen which your immune system is not prepared to handle. Thus, sexual relations with DBs and mutants is highly discouraged.
Concerning mutants, there is one major exception to mutants in our ranks, and that's Psystalkers. Among those Psystalkers who have embraced civilization and taken steps to assimilate into normal human society may join the coalition military. In the military, Psystalkers often head dog packs and specialize in hunting down magic users and psychics. They have as a group made themselves invaluable in our efforts against the supernatural, through determination and pure grit. Indeed, the face of our empire was in part forged by their hard work, and of all the mutants classified, none have stepped up more to prove they are just as human as us. They have as a group clawed their way up from the dregs to stand alongside us in our great nation. They have not shirked their duty, or wavered. Just remember, among the supernatural, powerful forces are easily corrupted, and given that, superpowered by birth or even horrific-looking human mutants are susceptible to becoming allies among one another, or with forces that would seek to bring suffering among us. These creatures are monsters and are never knowingly allowed into the cities for any reason. These are just a few of the hard truths that we have had to learn over decades. Hard truths you too, have most likely had to learn. In short, we are better than them because of our humanity, and only by working together as a unified people can we ever hope to weather the storm of the unnatural creatures that seek to bring a final chapter to humanity. Thank you for your application for citizenship. While you wait to speak to your appointed caseworker, be sure to view more videos on Coalition citizenship to ease your transition into our nation. With luck, you will soon stand under our shared banner of the Empire and find peace, shelter, opportunity, and security.
Loyalty for the citizen.
Honor for the soldier.
Glory for the nation.
Strength to the emperor.
Ad victoriam.